The universe is made of questions. Good one, right? So for an astronomer, I mean, that's what we do. We think up questions and we try to find the answers to those questions. But the big universe is just, it's made out of dark matter and we don't know what dark matter is, so that's the question. I asked my folks for a telescope one year for Christmas, and I spent hours late at night in my backyard scanning the sky for whatever my little telescope could spot. And I accidentally saw Saturn one day through my telescope. I looked at Saturn for 2 hours straight that night in the freezing cold. The Rothney is the best observatory, bar none. It belongs to the University of Calgary. Got these beautiful cameras and telescopes. We do take pretty pictures of the sky, but that's not the goal. The goal is to do science, to answer a question using telescopes and detectors. And our students, if they want to do anything, they come straight here and they can do it. You know. You hear about black holes, they suck up everything, they destroy everything. But actually, when you're far away from them, they just orbit around stuff. If the sun turned into a black hole, that's a different story. But it's not going to turn into a black hole, so don't worry. The Earth does go around the sun over a giant orbit, but the stars are so, so far away. You have to have a telescope and great detectors to see the actual motion that goes on. The best measurements of that are made by telescopes in orbit. And that gives you the distances. You can nail the distances to those stars using just geometry. Then you learn about the properties of stars. And then you look at other stars and you see their properties. And if they're like these ones over here, you can map out their distances. It's a lot of work. Telescopes are data collecting tools. We've come up with a lot of cool ideas for how to get better data. And there's always the trickle-down effect. Radio astronomy, oh my gosh. With my telescope, I have some fancy jazzy cameras and they can take 10 exposures a second. So great. Radio telescopes, they can take thousands of images a second. And the trickle-down effect is this little device right here in your hand uses radio to talk to grandma, because the technology that's in your phone was built because somebody wanted to get better data from space. We can predict when eclipses are gonna happen and where on the Earth you need to be, because an eclipse is just, you know, the moon's shadow is gonna hit the Earth. If you're in that shadow and you look up into the sky, you see the moon passing in front of the sun. And that is rockin' cool stuff. We've learned a lot about the solar system and the sun by watching eclipses. People didn't know how far the moon was or how far the sun was before. We didn't know what the sun was made out of. And people took the spectrum of sunlight during an eclipse and discovered things about the sun we never knew before. Here's a fun fact. When an astronomer discovers an asteroid, the asteroid is never named for its discoverer. It gets numbered. The name tells you when it was discovered, essentially. If you get special permission, you can name it, but you can't name it after yourself. That's the rules of the International Astronomical Union. But if you discover a comet, different story, you can name that comet after yourself. The term retrograde is an actual real thing that happens. So among all the stars, there's a few dots that aren't doing what the rest of the dots are doing. They're wandering around. And the Greek word for wander is planet. So the planets, if you're looking at like Venus and Mercury, they whip around the sky like crazy. Even in one night, you'll notice that they've moved from place to place. And if you notice these wandering stars from night to night, they move toward the east. Except sometimes they go the other way. And that is their retrograde motion. I think there's a little astronomer inside of everybody, and there's nothing more fun than setting up a telescope underneath some dark, starry-filled skies and get people to spot Saturn, and they'll just look at Saturn for like 2 hours going, wow. And then the questions just pop up, right? That's the most fun thing, if people ask you the best questions. If people don't think about the stars and they're not engaged with the stars, there's just gonna be more and more lights in our cities and the stars are gonna disappear. So I think what we can do as astronomers is just to get people reconnected to the stars.